Hello, fourth grade. It's time for another math test, and this is the second to the last math test of the year. So that is exciting. By the way, that little riddle math puzzler that I mentioned the other morning, what numbers when added together equal the same thing they do when they're multiplied by each other. For those of you that may not know the answer to that, the answers were 1, 2, and 3. Check it out. I got some responses from y'all. Good job, those of you that figured it out. Okay, let's review for today's math test. I want to remind you of what I talked about yesterday in division. Remember, division is just figuring out how many times the divisor goes into the dividend. And we break the dividend down into small bites so that we can divide easier. We don't try to take this number into the whole thing at one time. We break it down into little bites. So we start with, we try to take it as small a bite as possible, so that ends up being those two numbers. And then you just go through all the steps. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then start over again, at least if the dividend has more digits in it than the divisor. So, yeah, follow the 5 steps. And I think you'll do fine. Let's review place value. What is the place value of decimals? Well, if you remember, you should be thinking about this as the middle. The ones place as the middle. And so everything on each side, as you go to the right, I'm sorry, as you go to the left, or as you go to the right, is the same thing. It's just that when you go to the right, after the decimal point, you add the th, right? So this is tens, this is tenths, this is hundreds, this is hundredths, with a ths on the end. Maybe I should write that in. There we go. Okay, so remember that. So that means that whenever you change a fraction to a decimal, you should think about place value. If you still haven't, if you still aren't confident doing this, I noticed that most of you are doing a pretty good job with this. Actually, you're doing a fantastic job. I noticed one person, when I graded your papers from last week, that was floundering a little bit. So when you change something like this to a decimal, look at the denominator. That tells you where the last figure up here goes. And of course, there's only one figure up here in this illustration, so it goes in the hundredths place. That means a decimal point and a zero to get us to the hundredths place, and then the 5. Okay. Now, one more thing, and this I think is pretty important. Whenever your directions say estimate, estimate, then that's what it means. Estimate. So don't figure it out by using the figures that are given. You're supposed to round, right? When it says estimate, you're supposed to round something before you figure it out. So I'm just going to go over what you should round. When you have a division problem, you round the dividend to the largest place value. So think about that as 400. And you can almost get the answer just like that, right? Divide 2 into 4 and then add 2 zeros. So estimating is easier. Take advantage of that. Because it's easier, and also you'll get it wrong if you don't estimate. One is a multiplication problem. You round the multiplicand to the largest place value, which in this case would be 8,000, and then multiply. Now that's pretty easy. All you do is 3 zeros, and then multiply 8 times 6. Isn't that so much easier? And a subtraction problem, you end up rounding both figures to the largest place value. So 70 and 30, and then subtracting, and you can get the answer just like that, 40. Addition, you do the same thing as you would do in subtraction. You round both to the largest place value. And this one would be 7,000, right? And then you can add that really easily, very easily. So again, follow the directions. It says estimate. Don't work it out the usual way, because you will have to estimate in today's math test. Okay, that is all to review this morning. So yeah, take your time in your math test. It's not a race.